A very good morning to you children. At the outset, on the auspicious occasion of Air Force Day, that is 8th October 2020, I extend my warm wishes to you as well as your families. Established in 1932, Indian Air Force has served 88 glorious years to this nation. It has widened its wings and today has gained the status of fourth largest air forces in the world. I feel extremely proud and privileged to have been a part of this elite workforce. Indian Air Force is known for its strong work ethics, energetic teamwork, and also in accomplishing Herculean tasks in the most challenging and life-threatening circumstances. Be it a mission with a deadline or be it a rescue operation, Indian Air Force has been proving its mettle since 88 years. Children, what opinion do you hold for a military person? I am sure that you have a lot of appreciation and a lot of respect. But I would like to mention that the appreciation and the respect is only one side of the coin. The other side of the coin harbors such wonderful qualities that have to be followed by every citizen of this country. Having served for 23 years, with Indian Air Force, I feel that this is the right occasion where I can share my experiential learning and certain good qualities which every citizen must possess. The first quality which I would like to tell you today is, yes, you are right, children, it is discipline. Discipline is the most important quality which a person should have in his life. Discipline should be made as a way of life. Discipline means setting things into order. Discipline means being punctual. Discipline means you have decided some set of rules and regulations and a timetable for yourself. And also you are following it in letter and spirit. Discipline plays a pivotal role in designing our own life. So the first quality which every citizen of India should develop is discipline. The second important quality which I would like to express is to have commitment for excellence. Everybody should think big. Everybody should have highest standards of goals. When you set a goal for yourself, you should justify your potential. That goal should be larger than yourself. The goal should have been worked out in such a way that when you are in the process of achieving that goal, you are improvising yourself, you are enhancing your capabilities, because it is said that sometimes the process is more important than the goal itself. Commitment to excellence. You have to believe that you have been engineered to excel in life. The other quality is integrity to core. Integrity doesn't mean that you are just exhibiting a lot of respect and a lot of sincerity externally. No, integrity is always at the core. It is being honest even when you are not being watched by anyone. The other quality which I would like to mention here is developing the quality of facing challenges without losing confidence. Everybody on this planet has problems, but just think how many people are coping up and leading a healthier and happy life. Escaping from circumstances is not going to solve the problem. Understanding a problem, trying to solve with whatever intellectual capabilities you have. If not, taking the assistance of the higher intellectuals. And finally, finding a solution to a problem is the best way how we can get out of problems. It is said that the best way to get out of the problems is to go through it. You have to believe that a seed has to break the strong earth to grow and prosper in life. If you want to develop leadership qualities, you people should understand that you have to inhale problems and exhale solutions in life. Children, you being the future functional wheels of this country, today I have two messages for you. The first one is, whatever profession you are choosing in your life, make the country proud. When we say, I am proud of my country, let also the country feel that I am proud of my citizens. The second message which I would like to give you is, appreciation and respect is only one side of the coin. When you imbibe, instill the qualities which are considered specific to a military personnel, then you are really paying tribute to the personnel who are securing our borders, who are working 24/7/365 for the safety and security of this country. I once again wish a very happy Air Force Day to you all and express my gratitude to the school management for having given me this excellent opportunity to have expressed my feelings on this grand occasion of Air Force Day. Thank you and Jai Hind.